Hello and welcome to Norma Garage. Find out how to work easier, better and faster using original quality spare parts. My name's Jason. This is my colleague Rene.
Hey.
Hi Rene. What are you working on today?
I have a damaged fuel line here and I must repair this area. Can you help me with some parts?
Yeah, of course we can. Usually finding the correct parts is tedious. Today, we'll show you step by step how to get the vehicle ready in less than 5 minutes. With our fuel line repair kit, you have all the necessary spare parts ready at hand in a small toolbox. The box is made of sturdy plastic. It can withstand a lot of knocks. The repair kit is very well sorted. There are rubber hoses in various sizes. Have a mini clamp to secure the rubber hose. Quick connectors in different sizes. And also brass sleeves to stabilize the fuel line when covered with the rubber hose and tightened. If you run low on any part, it is really easy to reorder. Just use the part number on the inside of the box. First, separate the defective fuel line by cutting out the leaky part. You can use a knife, but it is safer with a pair of scissors. We'll keep the broken fuel line so we can measure the correct length of the rubber hose. Then determine the inner diameter of the fuel line and select the appropriate sleeve size.
Little tip from me, warming the tube.
Hey Rene, great idea. The sleeve is easy to insert when the tube is heated by using hot water, a hairdryer, or even a little oil. Never, ever use a naked flame when working on a fuel line. The sleeve gives the tube more stability. Now determine the outer diameter of the tube so you can choose the appropriate rubber hose. Be sure to measure the length of the hose correctly so that the quick connector profile and the sleeve are covered.
And now we insert the fuel line with the sleeve into the rubber hose. My tip, be sure to place the upper mini clamp over the sleeve so that the fuel line will not be damaged.
Rene, that's correct. If we forget to do this, we would have to start all over again. Now put the quick connector on the other side of the hose and tighten it with an ABBA mini clamp. Then connect the quick connector with the spigot. Rene, I've been thinking, what if the leakage isn't near the fuel tank?
This is not a problem. We repeat the steps from before on the other side and insert the fuel line with the sleeve into this hose.
Ah, okay. Rene, hi. That was a fantastic job. That's really well done. That was under 5 minutes. That's us done today in the Norma Garage. Thanks for tuning in. You're Jason.
And Rene.
And if you like, visit our homepage.